Hey Sagittarius, welcome to your love reading. Let's find out what's going on with your partners or your soulmates out there. Where is your soulmate out there, right? If you're new, welcome. Please remember to subscribe and hit that notification bell so you get all the messages I post each month. Welcome back to my lovely loyal subscribers. You guys have been here for me the last 3 years, so it is a change of scenery, but I'll be back to my desk the next time I post readings. Just a little bit cold up there today. So let's see. Past life relationship. Okay, Sagittarius, I see you. You have known each other before. Let's see. Make the effort. Okay, great love is worth taking the steps you're guided to take here. I mean, I've raved so much about Sagittarius. They're going to have an amazing 2020. So I'm not surprised if you're going to meet somebody from your past life or a major relationship is coming together. And this is why you're being asked, look, make the effort. I always laugh when I always pull the make the effort card for myself. A new person has stirred your romantic feelings. So, yeah, you're definitely going to be either falling in love this year or getting together with the one that you're going to spend a lot of time with, a long time. So make the most of it and make the effort. Enjoy your single life for now, right? Because you're about to be locked up in a relationship long term here. Let's see. Okay, King of Winter. This is very positive. Knowledgeable, experienced, fair-minded, unemotional. Get advice from somebody professional and objective. Public speaking, unemotional relationship. So you could be asking somebody older than you or somebody with more experience than you for advice on this relationship. Like, how should I play this? I've just met this new person. Let things unfold naturally. Play it slow, guys. Have a lot of fun. And look at this, Ace of Springs, a lot of passion. A lot of excitement coming your way. It's time to take action. Be fearless and happily pursue your most treasured dreams and amazing career opportunities. Definitely coming your way. It's going to be a wonderful year. I know a lot of us have said, no, it's not. But if you're doing something creative, it's really going to take off at this time. Amazing career opportunities coming your way. The Nine of Summers, wishes come true, dreams fulfilled, and a magical time of life. I told you guys, it's going to be absolute magical time of life for you guys. King of Swords, somebody swiftly moving towards you. It's suggesting new love, but it's saying you've known each other before. So you'll have this instant connection because it's like some sort of past life relationship, either via karma or a soulmate, but it's going to be wonderful. I'm telling you, they're going to be your ninth cup here. It'll be beautiful. With a lot of excitement with that Ace of Wands. King of Cups, they're ready for love. I've seen a lot actually in Scorpio readings, a Sag coming towards them. So maybe a King of Cups coming towards you. Fire and water do make steam after all, right? Leos have had their chance with Scorpio. Time for some fun and love and excitement. With a Sagittarius, I'm guessing. Three of Cups, look at this. And Scorpios as well, I predicted for marriage this year. So you could end up getting married or having a baby this year with somebody who is considered to be your ninth cup, the one for you. You've spent many lifetimes together and they're really coming in quickly now. That's that King of Swords energy, but the King of Water energy is saying, I'm ready for love. This is somebody who's ready to love. They've gained experience maybe through other things, but they are ready for love now and ready for this commitment with the Three of Cups. They've done their exploring. They've gained their knowledge here and they'll probably reach out with the Ace of Wands. So exciting times for you guys, right? Let's see. The Devil. Not many people know this is a marriage card as well because it's two people chained together, right? It can be that you guys didn't come together in this life just yet because you had other karmic debt to work out or other things from your past life that needed sorting out first, or any codependencies or addictions going on with you personally may have had to be fixed, or them, okay, may have had to be healed. But what we want to see after this is the strength card, right, to say you've overcome that devil energy. And that means they'll be coming in a lot quicker, this new person. So let's see. Two of Cups. I'm telling you, it's all pointing to love. I mean, I can't wait for somebody. I can't wait to meet somebody as well. Three of Cups, Two of Cups, the Hanged Man. You're going to have a major wake-up call here from a soulmate. They're going to sweep you off your feet. Look at this. This, you're not expecting this, but it's not going to come as a tower. It may feel like it because it's such a surprise, but this person will sweep you off your feet here and blow your mind in more areas than one. The Chariot. Look at this. This is destiny stepping in and getting you on track to meet each other. So cute. It's so cute. I love to watch people meet in and things like that. I think I told you guys I wanted to create this dating thing. So, yeah, I really love it when I see a love blossoming here. And that's really what's going on. Prince of Cups. So here they come with their offer, right? Destiny's really going to help them find you. So you may be thinking, how can they meet me? I can't get out of this house. Well, we all have to go to the shop, so make the effort when you go shopping. Make sure you've got a fresh trim, guys, or, you know, girls, make sure you haven't got your pajamas on at least, right? I know people are starting to slip these days, but make sure you've got some clothes on at least, right? It doesn't really matter about makeup and things. I think this person and you will just look into each other's eyes and then game over. It's like happily ever after. It's your Ten of Cups here. Soon as you look into each other's eyes, didn't I call it, it's game over. You guys can see this future with a rainbow over your house, picket fence here, some children. Be careful if you don't want children. That Three of Cups is there, right? But there's a lot of beautiful new beginnings coming for you guys. So embrace them, enjoy them, and expect them. Okay, if you want to manifest them, tell yourself they've already happened. Good luck, guys.